Going on today, guys. JD at JD's Custom Buggy. So, what I've got here is a American Sportworks carbide. It's one of the race machines, number 07. So, last season, I guess the owner had made a shock change. All right, put a shock here. What he didn't take into consideration, though, which you have to be careful with when you're doing a shock change on anything with a dog bone, is if you notice the dog bone sits static, almost vertical, okay? And when that happens, this is what happens. It overextends, the motor can pop up and actually point towards the gas tank, which in a stock position, this dog bone needs to be pointed this way. Basically, the bottom needs to be, you know, it needs to be forward pointing, okay? If that's the case, then you can't, you know, yanking on this, it won't overextend. It can't come up because of the angle change on it. If you put a longer shock and it causes your bottom dog bone mount to be behind the top one, then, you know, anywhere from basically 6 o'clock back, if we clocked it, you know, 4, 5, 4, 3, you're gonna get this effect, okay? And we wanna avoid that, because anytime the wheels leave the ground, that can happen. If you get rear-ended too hard, that, you know, that can happen. So what I'm gonna show you is, we need to put a set of blaster shocks on here. Unfortunately, the way I would normally do it would be, I would put it on jack stands, the swing arm and the chassis, at the exact angle as the stock shocks would be. These look like they came off of something newer, like a Trailmaster or a Hammerhead, is my guess. So, how I would normally do it, if it was a stock machine, I would park it on jack stands and make it so when I took the shocks off, that this was at the exact angle it was in the stock position. We don't have that now. So what I'm going to do is basically set it up by eye how I think it should be, and then basically get my shock mounted. So this video will be basically a step-by-step. I'm gonna get it prepped first. I'll start the camera again and whatnot, just because I'm here by myself today. So I don't really have a cameraman, and we could skip a bunch of time and just kind of showing you step-by-step how to do it. All right, so I got the wheels off, we got the shocks off. This is basically where it was sitting static all along. Again, you can see what happens. All right, I have it back on a jack. Now, as I jack this up, okay, you can see that kind of stops. And with the shock, you got to remember, there's going to be a shock absorber here tying this together. So right now I'm moving because this whole thing on the bottom is pretty free. All right. So I would say it needs to be about right there. And if you look at a stock one, it is about right there. So I'm going to step on this. I'm up off the jack stand too, so, but you can see I can't pull it up now, okay? So what we're going to do is I'm going to get jack stands, put them under the swing arm. I'm trying to get everything level. I'm actually going to take a level, and get it all straightened out. So you can jack stand it anywhere. Axle. I want a little more than that, so I'm gonna find a different place. Let's see if I drop it there. And let's see. I don't think I have my jack stand level either. Alright, so to say. This one needs to come up one. I'm off the jack stand over here, I noticed. There we go. That might make it a little more, less wobbly. Now, that gives a better idea. So let me find a matching jack stand for the other side, and then I'll get a level. Check it out. There we go. Unfortunately, I've got like three or four different sets of jack stands, two different brands, so you want to make sure that you use the same brand jack stand or at least the match set when doing this. Let's cut that one more. That it? No, that, see? I just did it to myself. So, I got these two are matchy-matchy. These will be the two I use. Put under the axle. Check one. Bushings in those things. You can see the wiggle. That's the bushings. They're completely shot. Have to be something I tell him he's going to have to address when I get this all done. All right. But I'm confident you can see if you drew a straight line down, the bottom bolt's in front of the top bolt. Go a little more. That'd probably be safer yet. Okay. Now, I know some of you guys are like, oh, but you're going to lose ground clearance. No, you're not, because you're only, I don't care what you do, the only way to get ground clearance on these is to enlarge the tires. If you feel you need the ground clearance. I've been driving on 20-inch rear tires for the last 12 years. Never got hung up ever. Not in the earth dog. So, I kind of think, you know, if you have a decent amount of ground clearance, I think it's overrated. Changing. If you really want ground clearance, I would say invest in taller front tire and make them work on the buggy. You might need to get a spacer, depending on the buggy. These buggies usually come stock with an 8-inch wheel and a 20-inch tire. Go with the 10-inch and 22-inch. And that'll give you ground clearance because you're much more apt to bulldoze the front end into something than you are to drag the ass end and not make it through something. So, now, what I want to do is grab a level. What's funny is this bar from the factory is unbelievably crooked. If I use that, I'm going to be way off. This bar seemed to be pretty straight. Now, that's fairly level. I'm going to check my swing arm. But again, this isn't very impressive. And it's not the first. Like, the back of the swing arm is much more level than the front because of the way it's hanging. Check my axle. Axle's level. That's kind of the most important thing for me. This whole chassis, I knew when I put this gas tank mount on, this down tube and this down tube had to be two different lengths. This was level. This was not. So, I'm thinking I'm pretty safe to go with that right there. All right, so apparently, gonna grab a set of blaster shocks over here. I don't know where he got them from, but somebody decided to go at them with the spray paint. Now, length-wise, you can see the blaster is longer. Not only that, but the boss is a lot wider. So what's going to happen is, see, this tube is in my way. Apparently, I'm going to have to cut this out. My goal is basically going to be, which there's really nothing supporting it here. There's no more rack. The swing arm pivots here, but there's not a whole lot of stress. All the stress is going to fall on the shock and the mounts right there. So I'm probably just going to cut this bar out of the way. Cut these shock mounts off of. Well, let me get the camera pointed right. Like I said, all right, so this bar is in my way. I'm going to cut these shock mounts out of the way, and as long as when the finished product is done, I have an angle like that, and it'll keep it from overextending, because that was the biggest problem. So, I'm going to lop one of these off of each side also, make some tabs, and get her welded in place. So let me get my stuff together, and then we'll get back to it. All right, we got our shock mocked up, made some mounts, and just basically got them welded into place. What I did, just a tip, so I have a tab here that's bent back down to the swing arm, because obviously I'm using the inside tab, one, for ease, two, for a point of reference, and then, so this bottom tab, I actually put the vise and hammered it, so it's got a bend to it that goes back to the swing arm. Up here, so they're going to be the same. I have two washers between the shock and the frame, and then I basically just lean it up with the mounts mounted to it. I'm going to tack them and see if I can get a weld, or at least I'm going to try and be gentle around them. Obviously, I'm welding around everything on the buggy at this point, but being I'm in a rush, I don't have time to pull the seat and all that, and this was a last minute type deal. So, if you notice, my dog bone link is at a lot better angle now. There's no way that's going to hyperextend anymore. So, basically, you just have to reload count and account for the length of the difference in the length of the shock that you're going to use. So, let's get this kind of tacked back into place here. It's grinding. Forgot to change helmets. Thank you. side's tacked, I'll tack the other side, finish welding it up. We'll give it a tug. As far as this is concerned, I did cut it out of the way just enough for the shock. I am gonna have to find a different place to tie this into. My options are either I bring it from here to here, or I gotta do something different. I just don't know if these two bars sticking out this way. I mean, they are tied back into the frame here, so I gotta give it some thought. I might just cut it out and just call it a day because we are squared up here. Well, when we're done, we'll have a finished product, hopefully. All right, so we got everything welded up. So as you can see now, it's on the ground with the shocks on it. We have longer shocks, obviously, because they're mounted way higher than they were before. Because I have this tank mount all welded into the cage, I think we'll be okay there. But if you pull up on a swing arm, which you can't overextend anymore, and that's what the original issue was. So I think we've cured the problem for now. So just the moral story is you can't just slap any length of shock on a dog bone swing arm that you want, otherwise you'll run into a similar problem. So if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section. If you like what you see, like and subscribe. If you need parts, go to gotbuggies.com. All right, guys, JD's out.